which corresponds, which are solution and corresponds to these constant values of the input. Okay, so in other words, what we have to find now before going to the Taylor expansion are the values of our solution X E which corresponds to these values of the input, or a solution which corresponds to this value of the input. Okay, so once we have this, we will linearize around the values of U given by VE and omega E, and the values of X given by XET of T. So this. Okay. So actually, once this seems difficult, but it's quite mechanical in the sense that we have to look at the nonlinear model equations and imagine to apply exactly this constant inputs and calculate analytically the solution, which in general is not a difficult task, for example. So now consider the model equation and set input the input equal to V E omega E. So imagine to apply this constant input to the model. So what we want to obtain is the corresponding solution. Okay, so we have this. We have dot here. Okay, so we are considering now this particular system of equations, which are obtained from the nonlinear, the general nonlinear model, and by setting the inputs exactly to the constant values VE omega E. So what we have to see now is exactly the analytical form of X E of T. So which are the functions E X E of T which correspond to this situation? Okay. So let's start from the last equation, which is the simplest. So from the last equation, you see that x3e dot is equal to constant omega e, and this is simple to solve, because this means that xe3 is equal to omega e t plus initial condition. So this is the solution which we are looking for, x3. Now, so for simplicity, you see that you obtain a family of solutions because are parameterized by initial conditions. Okay, so simplify and take zero initial conditions. So the solution which corresponds to zero initial condition is this. is exactly omega et. Now you see you can replace x3e inside the two above differential equations. And solve for x1 and x2e. Okay? So this is ve cos omega et, and this is ve sinus omega et. And again, it's very simple to solve this differential equation. You see? Because b is constant, and you see that x1e is equal to a cosinus, and x2.e is equal to a sinus. So, we go directly to the solution, but it's very easy to check that this is it. Okay, so x3e is omega t, omega et, x1et is ve over omega e, this is the solution, sinus of omega et. You can check this directly. Actually, here we have initial conditions again, but we assume zero initial conditions. And similarly, the other solution is V of minus, minus because you have the cosinus, minus V omega e, cosinus omega e t plus, and this again is zero. So you see that it's not difficult in general to obtain this. Okay, so now you have the pair of functions given by x e of t, which is this vector function, and it is the solution of the nonlinear model corresponding with zero initial conditions, corresponding to constant inputs equal to VE and omega E. Okay, and this is your UE of T. So in general, so what you obtain is a pair XE of T, UE of T, which is de facto a solution of your model. Okay. So you obtain xe of t and ue of t, which in practice is a solution of your nonlinear model. So which means, mathematically, that the time derivative of x, xe of t is equal to f okay. And this, as you are seen is by construction of this pair x e u e. So we obtain this from the nonlinear model exactly as a solution of the model. So this pair solves identically our differential equations. So we write this. Okay. So now, to see how linearized the system, we will start from this point. In general, this is the starting point. So you need to have a hand available, a pair like this, which is a solution of your nonlinear model. You can select this solution among all the possible from physical considerations, physical intuitions. For example, in the case of a robotic platform, we decided to linearize around the situation which corresponds to the robotic platform moving with constant angular and linear position. For the pendulum, we have the similar situation. We linearize around the downward or upward position, which are actually solutions of the model. Okay. For example, if you consider the pendulum, we can also in this case see how to obtain these functions x, x, e, and u, e. So, for the pendulum, remember that we have the following equations. Now, intuition, for example, says that we can linearize, or we can try, we try to linearize around two possible positions, which correspond to solutions of the nonlinear model, which are the downward position and the upward position. So, downward position corresponds to angular position equal to zero downward. The reference axis is the vertical downward, so angular position is zero. And angular velocity zero. Okay, so in particular, it's clear that these values 0 and 0 are exactly our functions x1e and x2e. Okay. The upward position instead is x one pi and x two zero. Again, these values are x one e and x two e. So different. One is 0, 0, and the other is pi, 0. Now, in this model we have, we are not including the input, which is the force we may apply to the pendulum. So, the value of ue in this case is zero because actually we even don't have input in this in this case. But obviously if we imagine to include the action, the possible action of a force on the pendulum, obviously this contribution will enter on the angular acceleration, which is x2 dot. Okay, so what you have is the contribution here of a force which stands for an input, a control input. Okay, so now it makes sense also to have UE, okay, which corresponds to XE in this case. And you have to do basically the same thing you did in the case of the robotic platform. So replace. In this case, what you have is not UE as in the robotic platform, but you have first XE. The robotic platform, first you fix UE and then you found XE. Here you have first XE and you have to see what is UE. So what you do, you replace again these values inside the differential equations. Okay, so again, what you have to do is to again guarantee that your choice of XE solves the nonlinear equation with a suitable choice accordingly of UE. So and UE. So now you are first XE and now you determine UE, which in some sense together with XE solves the differential equations. Okay, so basically in this case, because you have a constant value, it's a constant solution in this case. So zero, zero dot is zero. Excuse me, constant dot is zero. Remember that x1e is constant. x2e, okay, this depends on, we have two cases, upper and downward position. But in both cases, x2e is zero. So you see that the first equation is identically satisfied. Let's go to the next differential equation. Zero dot is zero. X2e is zero. This. So here we have different cases. One is downward position and the second is upward position, because we have different values of x1e, 0 or pi. However, you see that x1e appears under the sinus. So the sinus of 0 or pi is the same and is 0. Okay. So this term is 0 in both cases. If it's 0 or if it's pi. inside this differential equation, which is zero. Okay, so according to upward or choosing upward or downward position, we have two different pairs, X, E, U, E, to be selected. For the upward position, X, E is pi 0 and UE is 0. So this is the solution corresponding to the upward position of the pendulum. For the downward position, we have this, which is 0 for XE and 0 for UE. Okay. So, before I'm going to a new blackboard here, and let's get back to the previous one. So you see that this is the situation we have to start from. So basically, we have the nonlinear model. We have then to, if you want, to linearize around a solution of the nonlinear model. This solution may be found, as we have seen in these examples, for example, saying physically what is the configuration we want to refer to. For example, constant angular velocity, still in some position, and so on. All these configurations correspond with suitable choices of the inputs, in general, to solutions of the nonlinear model. Okay. So in this way, in general, we come up with a pair given by x, e of t and u, e of t, which are solutions of the nonlinear model in this sense that solves and these pairs of this pair of functions solves identically the nonlinear equation. Okay. Now, once you have this, we can, let's see what is our linearized model. So, start from the nonlinear equations. Remember that you have your functions xe and t and u e of t, which are solutions of your nonlinear model. Okay, so besides the model, you have also these pairs of functions x e u e of t, notice that y e of t is the output function which corresponds to these pairs of functions. So you just replace XE and UE inside the output equation and you get YE of T. This. Okay. So this is obtained directly from this. Simply replacing XT on UT with the given functions XE of T and UE of T. Okay, this is a simple operation. Okay, so basically this is your model corresponding to that solution. X E of T U E of T with the output equation. Now what you do is to write the Taylor expansion of F and H around X E of T U E of T. So let's this for example for F. Okay. Remember that the Taylor expansion is this around the pair XE UE. So it's the value of the function at that point that in those functions. So this plus. The Jacobian of F with respect to X U and X and U, so it's the matrix of the partial derivatives of F with respect to all its variables X and U. This is the Jacobian of F. Evaluated. And this is a matrix of nonlinear functions. So you evaluate this matrix, the functions of this matrix, at XE, UE. Obviously, if XE, UE are constant, this is a constant matrix. Otherwise, is a time-varying matrix multiplied the variations okay, so this is the product of a matrix with a vector okay. It is the vector given by x minus x e of t and u minus u of e of t. Okay, the increment. And plus, I don't want here, and simply say that we have high order terms. Okay, so the game here is to select only the first order terms up to the first order. So constant, first term and second term. Okay. Now, what we have to do is to place our approximation inside the system equation. Okay, and so that to have x dot equal to f x, so here we are approximating. Now. So x e t u e t plus Let's split the Jacobian in two parts, in two matrices. The one which is the Jacobian with partial derivatives with respect to x, and the other with respect to u. Okay, and so that we can split that term in this way. Plus okay, it's the same, huh? This term. These terms are the same. We simply divided the two contributions. Okay. Now, notice that if you go here, fx e of t u e of t is exactly x e of t dot. Okay. Now, moreover, let's call the Jacobian of f with partial derivative with respect to x as a of t. So it's a matrix depending on time. Similarly, let's call the Jacobian of f with partial derivatives in u, as the u, evaluated at the functions x, e of t, u of t, as b of t. Okay. So it's clear that from this equation you obtain this. X dot equal xc dot plus a of t x x plus b of t u minus u of t. Now, it's clear what we are doing here. Let's call z x minus xe and v u minus ue. What are these variables? These are nothing but the displacements of the state variable and the input variable of the nonlinear model from the linearizing values. So with these positions from this equation we get, so let's consider these two together, which gives z dot. Okay, so you take this and carry this on the other side. So you get z dot. equal A of t z dot plus B of t V of t. Okay, what we have here is the linearized model. You see that the linearized model differs from the non-linear model in what? You see that here you have now a linear differential equation with, in general, non-constant coefficients, time varying. This coefficients will be obviously constant when xe and ue are constant. Okay, so for example, in the case of the pendulum, the matrices A and B will be constant. But in the case of the robotic platform, these matrices will not be constant, but time varying. Remember that x e of t is not constant in the case. Okay. So this is the linearized model, and the main peculiarity of this model is, first of all, the fact that its state is not the state of the nonlinear model, but is the variation from that state with respect to the linearized value, linearizing value. And the same for the input. The input of the linearized model is not the input of the nonlinear model, but it's the difference between the input of the nonlinear model with the linearized value, linearizing value of the input, which is QE. Okay? It's, that our linearized model describes not the absolute variation of the state, but the relative variations of the state around the linearizing value. Okay. And it is also obvious that the validity of this model is such as long as the variable z will be small. So not far from the linearizing values. Otherwise, our approximation is no more good, because in this case the nonlinear contribution in the Taylor expansion will be significant and no more neglectable. Okay. So to conclude, basically the same we can